Hello everyone, today I'm going to discuss about IDE. IDE is nothing but Integrated Development Environment, which is a software for building applications that combine together into a graphical user interface. It's a combination of source code, local build automation, and a debugger. The main difference between the code editor and the IDE, the code editor only offers syntax highlighting, multi-view, and previewing the windows, whereas IDE allows user to debug and also contains the text editor, and user can also run the unit test and also contains the code completion. And there are features like extension where we can install the plugins, and we have the built-in terminals. So why do we need an IDE? So for managing all the aspects of the development process, we need like IDE to improve the productivity and the quality of code. And user can only concentrate on the logic, not like building the application or like running the application. All those things are like covered like with the help of the IDE. And there are many IDEs available in the market. Some of them are like Visual Studio, IntelliJ, PyCharm, WebStorm, and NetBeans. So today I'm only discussing about how we can get like free version of the IntelliJ for the students. So to do that, navigate to the browser and search for the IntelliJ on the website. You can see the top search, click on it, and then go for the education button, and you can see the free license for the student and teacher, click on it. And then if you navigate down, you can see the apply now button. So you have like four different ways of like getting the free version. So one of it is like using the email address. Like if you have international student ID card, you can use the second option, or else you can use the official document where you need to provide the student ID card. And the other way is using the GitHub. You need to log into your GitHub account for the student. So I'm going to only use the first using the email address. You need to fill all the required details. Once you complete all the required details, you need to click on apply for free products. And once you're done, like you'll be able to get an email in 5 minutes with the access code. Once you get that, you can able to download the IntelliJ version. After clicking on apply for free products, you'll be navigated to this page where it confirms that it has sent the instructions to the email address. So this is the email that you will be getting for the IntelliJ. So where it contains a link. Using that link, you need to create an account. So I already created an account. So and also downloaded the IntelliJ. So I'm opening the application. So you'll be seeing this window where you need to drag that into the application folder. So it will take few seconds in order to copy that into the application. So once after it copied, you need to open the IntelliJ. You can do it by command space. So it takes a few minutes in order to verify. After verifying, it asks you to open the application. You need to click on the open. So it provides you the user agreement. You need to confirm the user agreement and then click on the continue. And it asks for whether you need to share the statistic. For now, I'm not sharing the statistic. If you want, you can also share the statistic. And once you complete that, you'll be seeing this screen where you need to activate the IntelliJ. If you click on the activate the IntelliJ, you can activate through account, or also you can use the activation code. So that's it for this video. Thank you all. We'll see you in the next class.